come on down. Hey, don't you wanna party? Party with me. Come on down. Who's ready to come on down? I need some winners. Let us break romance. Let the music come and move you. Let the beat get into you. Come and share with me. Come and dare with me. There is something about tonight. Cause I know this is right, baby. Let's have some fun. Okay, guys. I gotta tell you something. There's no game show that's complete without a prize girl, right? Do we need a prize girl for the game show? I think we do. Her name is Miss Bernadette. Would you give a hand for Miss Bernadette? Welcome her up to the stage with me.
Hello, hello, hello. Wow, you all made it. They're standing in the back.
So cool.
I love it. How are you doing, Renica?
I'm doing great.
You haven't sweat your face off yet. That's
good.
Not
yet. Give me a minute. This will all
I
just
know.
Run.
They have all the lights, the cameras, the action. I'm so happy to
That's
be
right.
here.
RSVP Cruisers, give yourselves a hand, a round of applause, because this room is full of winners tonight. I've got some great prizes for you.
And some attractive-looking winners at that. Make some noise for yourselves. Good looking. Good
Again,
looking.
My name's Renica. This is Bernadette. We're from Kansas City. This is the Dirty Game Show. We've been doing this about 6 years at Missy B's in Kansas City on first Wednesdays.
Come on
and
in and see
us. This is our second year on RSVP Vacations. Thank you guys so much for having us back. Quick show of hands. Is there anybody here that's from Kansas City? Anybody here from
Scott
Kansas City?
Scott and Terry in the back.
Oh, now those two right back. I see some more hands over here, didn't I? Yeah, I see two hands back there. These guys. That's Terry and Scott. Come forward just a little bit for me. I want to introduce these guys to you. Terry and Scott won their entire vacation in my game show in Kansas City. These guys won the cruise. They won the airfare. I've been sending bottles to their room this week. We're having fun. By the way, they're celebrating their 23rd wedding anniversary. And their second honeymoon. Give them a hand, guys. Uh-oh. Bernie, what do you say? You go get me two winners. I'll go get two winners.
Sounds
you go that
like
way,
a plan.
Way?
Yeah, let's do that.
Raise your hands. Who's in?
Two winners. Two. I saw you first serve. Why don't you come on up?
This one right here was screaming a while ago.
Anyone over here?
Yes.
Anyone? Red
I
shirt in the
one.
Back. Red shirt in the back. Come on down.
I've got one. Watch your step there, sweetie. Let's see. There's one right there. Either one. What's your favorite color?
Okay. Make yourself at home.
There's two. Oh, you got two real quick. I need one more. Oh, looky here, what I found. Come on up here, baby. Yes. Mark him right there. You know what I think we should do before
yes.
we play a little silliness is find out who our contestants are. So down there, you've got a red light and a red microphone, red button. Hit that button for us. Tell us your name.
David.
Make a little noise for David. Give him a big hand, would you?
Okay, David. Where are you from?
Denver.
David from Denver. And I trust that your journey wasn't too unpleasant, this, you know, getting down to Fort Lauderdale. No trouble?
Nope. It was fabulous.
Fantastic. Make some noise for him.
Contestant and number two, you got a blue light, blue microphone. What's your name?
Frank.
Say again?
Frank.
Hey, Frank.
Frank, make a little noise for Frank. Give him a hand, guys.
Where are you from, Frank?
New Jersey.
Frank from New Jersey. I like it. I like it. And I like the shirt, too.
Nordstrom.
Nordstrom?
Off the rack.
You know, I tend to make most of my clothing. I didn't buy this off the rack, but I think it's pretty.
It is. Very nice. Nice
thank
to
you.
My shirt.
Thank you. And sir?
Contest number three, got a green mic, green buzzer there. What's your name?
I'm Jason from Arizona.
Make
Jason,
a noise for
Jason from Arizona.
Give him a hand.
Where in Arizona?
Excellent.
Phoenix.
Phoenix? My sister lives in Tempe. She just moved there. She's a bitch. Whatever.
Contestant number four down here, you got a yellow microphone, yellow buzzer. What's your name?
Ricky.
Ricky, make a little noise for Ricky. Give him a hand, guys.
Where are you from, Ricky?
Richmond, Virginia.
Ricky from Richmond. I like it.
Well,
I like
let's
it.
Let's see here. I like to play a little, I don't even like to call it a trivia game. It's a little dirty trivia for you guys. And this round, we're going to play several different rounds tonight. This first round's called Dirty Minds. And we've all got them. But I'm looking for clean answers. Believe me, the questions I'm going to ask you, you're going to buzz in and give me that wrong answer. But that's what we're waiting for, guys. So I'm going to give you the first one just for fun. Bernadette will yell out the answer. She'll probably know this one.
Yep.
Max, I'll let the audience yell it out if they know. The first, I'll give you three hints, and then I'm looking for a clean answer, and I'll give you a hint. This starts with the letter M. The first time I did it, I was in fifth grade. I was kind of sloppy, and it ran all over my face. I never would at home because my mother wouldn't approve. So I always wiped it off before I went home. Makeup. As opposed to what you were thinking there in the beginning, uh-huh.
Get it out of the gutter, folks, all right?
Right. So, here's your first question, guys. And it starts with the letter R, as in RSVP. Are you ready? Here we go, guys. Give you three hints. First one to buzz in, give me a correct answer, gets 5 points. We'll play to 20 points for a winner and a nice little prize. Here we go. The more you play with me, the harder I get. I come in several colors, and you can get me in a million positions. Starts with the letter R. He's got it.
Recliner.
Ooh, that's a good answer, though. We'll try that later. We'll try that. Not the answer I was looking for. I should almost give him a half point for that. The more you play with me, the harder I get. I come in several colors, and you can get me in a million positions. It's about that big.
I think I know it.
I heard them yell out Rubik's Cube would have been the correct answer should any of you guys got that one. 5 points for the peanut gallery. Who yelled that out? Who yelled that? Bernie, come here. Give that. Who yelled that out? Go find them. They need that. Put that in their mouth. A little something for you to suck on there. Those are some Pop Rocks. Might keep him from yelling out the next answer.
One thing
answer,
you don't know about Renica. Renica is a candy junkie.
Oh, God.
Don't even think about it.
By the way, I've got Russell Stover's chocolates from Kansas City for you guys Saturday night to come back. Here we go. Things that start with the letter R. I'm going to skip that one. Things that start with the letter R. I can involve a tumble in the sack. When you're doing me, you're always in a hurry. When you're done with me, you're covered in sweat. We got a winner? You're on?
Revolve.
Good answer. Not the one I was looking for. Pull the bass down on their mics just a little bit. Here we go. One more time. I can involve a tumble in the sack. When you're doing me, you're always in a hurry. And when you're done with me, you're covered in sweat. Starts with the letter R. Four-letter word. Say again?
Romp.
Oh, no. The correct answer is race. We need to pull the low end down on the feed up here, guys. Thank you. Getting a little rumble back on that mic. Here we go. Next question. One more thing. It starts with the letter R. It's two words. Using me can cause a fight with your significant other. You grope for me under the covers to pump it up a notch. And if it wasn't for me, you'd have to get yourself up.
Remote control.
Just right here in my hand. That's 5 points. He's in this game. Okay, guys. Okay. Things that start with the letter R. One word. I've got a little pecker, and I can get you up in the morning.
Rooster.
Ooh, he's very quick. Nice job. Things that start
with
the letter R.
Not a cock. A rooster.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Things that start with letter R. I can have a cock in front of me. I can be a rug muncher. And if I've been in your crack, you might need to spray.
Rash.
In the mic?
Rash.
Ooh, good answer. Not the one I'm looking for. I can have a cock in front of me. I'm a rug muncher. And if I've been in your crack, you might need to spray.
Rottweiler.
Ooh, another good answer. Another good answer. Bernadette. Cock.
Tail. I don't know this one.
Cockroach. There we go. All right. Things that start with the letter R, guys. Four-letter word. When you eat me, you chew my bone. You can suck on me without getting my sauce on your chin. And I can have a
rib.
Nice, ribs is correct for five. Good job.
He's thinking now. He's in it.
Things that start with letter R. Two words. I can be a bloody pussy. I'm flat and hairy after you've been on top of me. And you're the last bang I'll ever have.
Rug?
Good answer. Good answer. Two words. Both four letters. I can be a bloody pussy. I'm flat and hairy after you've been on top of me or run over me. You're the last bang I'll ever have. Who's got it?
Road rash?
Road rash. It's roadkill. So close. One more from R. Things that start with letter R. I'm long and straight and can take your wide body. You need permission to come on me. And the shorter I am, the quicker you got to get it up. I'm long and straight and can take your wide body. You need permission to come on me. The shorter I am, the quicker you have to get it up. You guys were all on me.
Rowboat.
A what?
No! Rowboat.
Oh, good. You guys, almost all of you were on one just the other day.
Runway.
Runway would have been the correct answer I was looking for. All right. One more starts with the letter R. I'm a four-letter word that ends in U-N-T. A mother will sometimes eat me. I'm the smallest.
Runt.
Runt is correct. Who buzzed in? Ooh, he's quick down there. Good job. He got him five. So you wiped out my R. Nice job, guys. Let's how about try things that start with the letter S this time. You ready? Two words. After I get you up, you do it with your boots on. I pull you until you're at your peak. And when you get me off, it's time to go down. Oh, who buzzed in? Somebody? Anybody in? Reset. One more time. After I get you up, you do it with your boots on. I pull you until you're at your peak, and when you get off me, it's time to go down.
Skiing.
Skiing or ski lift is correct. You got that one. Good job. That's close enough. All right. So is he in the lead now?
Yeah.
He is. 15, 5, 5, and down here on the yellow buzzer. Rick, hit your buzzer for me. It does work. It does work. So, just trying. Things that start with the letter S. I hang below your waist. I almost always have a slit in the middle. And sometimes when you get me off, I...
Skirt.
Oh, who buzzed in? Down here in the red mic? What's your answer again?
Skirt.
You know what, guys? That means... that we have
a winner. And the other three don't go home empty-handed. In my right titty, I have free drink tickets to Village Pub in Fort Lauderdale when we get back.
Ooh, those will get used up, I'm sure.
In my left tit, right tit. Thank you, gentlemen. Go have your seats. We have some further business with our winner.
So, we got a winner, guys. Give him a great big hand, would you? You know what, Bernie? Here's what we should do. We should give him options. You can have what's in Bernadette's tight little box. Or what's in my fat sack.
Ooh, Renica got you some candy. We have condoms and Pop Rocks.
Ooh.
And some Russell Stover's
chocolates. Russell Stover's chocolates. How about a nice movie, something to do a little bit later? Silence of the Cams. I don't know.
Oh, and a condom. Wrap it up.
Give me my hand, guys. Nice job.
You know what I think?
Two more. Four more.
Four more winners.
Two more. Four more. Who's in, guys? Four more winners.
You in the blue, sir?
Volunteers or we'll draft you.
And in the red.
Oh, that went right there in the middle. Right there in the middle. Come on up here, baby. Hello. One more.
One more, Renica.
I need a screamer. I like screamers. Oh, there's a screamer. Oh, I heard it. I heard it right there making all that noise. Get up, get up, get up. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Climbing over. Oh, going that way. We got four.
Four more winners.
Excellent.
You know, Renica, I do have to say, I'm quite proud of you. You've managed to keep your hair on this whole time. That's very good.
Give me a second. I'm about ready to lose this 20-pound stocking cap in the Caribbean, guys.
Last February, we were about 3 minutes into our very first show, and I think you were so fed up, you took your hair off and threw it.
Yep.
And it got stuck in the chandelier of the MSC Divina. And poor Renica has Bernadette come out for the rescue and get the hair out of the lights.
I still had a show to host. Like right now, contestant number one, you got a red buzzer, red light, red microphone. Hit that. Tell us your name.
Daniel.
Daniel, make a little noise for Daniel. Guys, give him a big hand. Daniel, where are you from?
Denver.
Denver.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Denver's not far from Kansas City.
Yeah, a little bit.
That is the worst 8-hour drive there is in the history of the planet. If any of you have never driven from Kansas City to Denver, don't fucking do it. Think again.
I got a worse one for you. Don't drive from Kansas City to Fort Lauderdale. That was 1,750 miles to bring you guys this gear. Let's have some fun. Contestant number two, you got a blue microphone? Hit that again for me. And what's your name?
Bill.
Bill, where are you from?
Buffalo.
Buffalo, New York.
Bill from Buffalo.
Bill from Buffalo. Excellent. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
It's a lot warmer down here, isn't it? A lot warmer, yeah.
Contestant number three, you got a green microphone there. What's your name?
James.
James, where are you from?
Toronto.
What do you do for a living?
I'm an architect.
Excellent, excellent.
Do we have a Toronto delegation in the house somewhere?
Nice. Wow. And down there on the end, you got a yellow mic. What's your name?
My name's Chris.
Chris, thank you so much for joining us. What do you do for a living?
I'm an attorney.
Ooh.
Where are you from?
New York.
I think I just found the winner of this round. Yeah, there. All right, here we go. What should we play? I want to pick back up something else here. Just try some silly trivia questions with you guys. We're going to get some dirty answers this time.
I think so.
I think we are. Get ready on your buzzers. 5 points if you can tell me the correct answer I'm looking for. The act of dropping one scrotum onto the face of a companion is known as what?
Teabag.
Oh, who buzzed in? Oh, he's quick.
That was pretty quick.
My, my, my.
That was pretty quick. You were really ready for that one. Yeah, I know how it goes in Denver.
So do we got any ladies in the house tonight? Those lights up a little bit. Where's all my
girls? Saw a couple over here. Hi,
where's all my girls? Oh, they're going to get a kick out of this one. You guys ready on your butt? This will be funny because not one of them will get it. This is good. If the party where the guests are predominantly male is called a sausage fest, what is the female equivalent?
Fish fest?
See? When she asked me earlier, I said fish fry, and she told me I was wrong. Thank you for backing me up.
One more time, I'll try anybody want to steal that from me. If the party where the guests are predominantly males called a sausage fest, what is the female equivalent? Anybody want to try that? No answer. Girls, yell it out for me. Clam bake. Yeah. Okay. 5 points apiece. Here we go, guys. Eating a man's ass while giving him a reach around is known as?
Rim job.
No.
One more time. Eating a man's ass while giving him a reach around is known as?
A dirty trombone.
You're close. You're close. You're close.
Woo. We're all over that one, baby. Woo. Audience, yell it out. A couple of these guys may be able to get this one.
They didn't cover that in law school, I don't think.
Can you tell me what famous lesbian author enjoyed pot brownies? What famous lesbian author enjoyed pot brownies? Boy, she was a good cook. Anybody? Gertrude Stein. I heard somebody yell out there in the audience. All right. I'm going to try something else here with you guys. Tell me, what was Bruce Willis's battle cry in the movie Die Hard?
You were all alive. I know you were all alive for this.
Butter Kaye, motherfucker.
Is correct. He got him five. He's in this game. Here we go, guys. Get ready on your buzzers. What was Linda Blair masturbating with in The Exorcist?
A crucifix.
Yes, pretty. Woo, baby. We're going there, aren't we? 5 points if you can tell me, what was the name of the prisoner who flung his schmagma at Jodie Foster in Silence of the Lambs?
Whoa. That's a tough one. Whoa. Tough one.
Meeks?
Say again?
Meeks?
So close, so close.
So close.
Hannibal Lecter.
No. He was behind the glass. It would have just... It wouldn't have worked. He was in the cell next to him, Miggs. Miggs, you were so close with that one. I love it. In the ZZ Top song, what is in the shack outside LaGrange? There's a ZZ Top song. What is it? What is in that little shack outside of LaGrange? Ooh. That's a tough one.
That is a tough one.
That's a tough one.
I don't know
that
one.
These guys would think about whores, so we'll move on. All right. What Saved by the Bell star flaunted her jugs in the show Showgirls? It was a film, Showgirls. He's got it.
Elizabeth Berkley.
Is correct for 5 points. He's in this game. He is in. What do we got here so far? 5, 0, 5, and 10. All right. All right.
I'm rooting for Bill.
Get over here and feed him an answer. Cheat. Cheat.
All right, Bill. We're on the same team.
All right, guys. Here we go. One more question for you. What actress has dodged rumors that she's a hermaphrodite? On the tip of your tongue, and then...
Jamie Lee Curtis?
He is correct for 5. Good job there. 5 points if you can tell me. Upon his arrest, what term of affection did Mel Gibson use in reference to a female deputy?
Show your tits.
Is correct for 5. He's in this game. Oh, that one was cute.
Oh, my God.
In the television show South Park. Everybody seen South Park? What? And don't yell this out. Let's see if these guys can get it. What was the name of the animated turd that came to visit every Christmas? I'll give you a hint. It's Mr. Oh, he's in.
Hanky Poo.
Oh, he's close. Oh, buzz in. Buzz.
Mr. Hanky.
Is the correct answer. Yes. Yeah.
We just asked a question about an animated piece of shit. God, this week's going so well already.
In the movie Half Baked, everybody see Half Baked? Remember that? What did Bob Saget say that he used to do for cocaine? You guys saw it, they didn't, huh? Yell it out. He'd suck dick, that's right. All right. Didn't work.
I've done more for less, I can tell you that.
What song, what parody song did Justin Timberlake perform on Saturday Night Live?
Dick in a Box.
Is correct. He's got 10 points down there. Good job.
So do we have anyone at game point yet? Yeah, we're getting up there.
We're getting close. All right, here we go. Next question, guys. Pretty simple one here. Who sang the lines, "My anaconda don't want none if you ain't got buns, hon"? He's got that.
Sir Mix-a-Lot.
Is correct. And that means that once again, we have a winner. Nice job, man. Bernie, get rid of these losers for me. Jesus.
You don't talk to Bill like that. Bill's my friend. Here, get your drink, Bill. Okay, and we have some further business with our winner over here.
Okay. Yeah, hook him up.
Okay.
I think Mr. Hanky's in that box. So. Once again.
Boxer the bag.
Hey! You'll
take Renica's big sack.
All right. I like that. I think you'll like this too. Isn't she cute?
What a bunch of bears. You give it up. Oh my God.
Nice job, eh? Congratulations.
Why do we say we just give him the porn too?
Give him a dirty movie. I don't know if he's here by himself or what.
How about some Harry Potter?
Harry Potter, yes. Yes. That's it.
Have some fun. Renica, is it time?
Four more winners.
Four
Where
more
are they, guys?
Winners.
Screaming and hollering. Yeah, right here on the front row, I got one. That's easy. Right there, beautiful.
Sorry, he's got to climb over all of you. I'm sure you're not complaining.
There's two. You got two? I got one right here. He's in. Come on, beautiful. Excellent. Four
see,
more winners.
Renica, I do know that is your all-time favorite television game show. If anyone recognized the theme song, Match Game, that's right. My favorite, my personal favorite is $25,000 Pyramid. Makes noise for Pyramid fans. Yeah. Yeah, I knew that too.
He had one of those long microphones too, didn't he? Plugs right in.
Why don't we meet our winners, Renica?
Let's do that. Down here on the red buzzer.
Craig from Fort Lauderdale.
Craig from Fort Lauderdale. Excellent.
Craig,
thank you so much.
All the way from Fort Lauderdale.
That was a long swim.
It was tough.
Water's kind of chilly right now, isn't it?
Cold.
Look like you did good though. All right. Contest number two, you got a blue mic. What's your name?
Ken from DC.
Ken from DC.
Ken from DC.
Excellent. Excellent.
You know, I'm gonna just help these two out.
There you go. Down here, you got a green mic. And your name?
Josh from Salt Lake City, Utah.
Josh from Salt Lake City.
Salt Lake City, Utah.
That had to be a long walk. How many doors did you knock on the way? It's down here on the end of the yellow mic. What's your name?
Evan from New York.
Evan from New York.
Yes.
Evan from New York.
So how much snow was in your driveway when you left?
A driveway?
Right.
Okay.
We're from Kansas City.
Yeah.
Clearly.
Guys, I've got a driveway. It's 58 foot long. There's a 5 foot rock wall on each side. I got to shovel it all the way to the end and then out into the street. It really sucks. Reset the scores.
When was the last time you had to shovel your own driveway? I'd like to know. I don't think that's been anytime soon.
Okay.
No.
Don't count on that.
No.
Here we go, guys. Gonna change up the questions for you this time. We're gonna play a category round. All the answers are pussies. Okay? You guys ready? Get ready on your buzzers. Here we go. First question. First making motorcycle sidecars, what British luxury car manufacturer's slogan is grace, space, and pace?
Jaguar.
Is correct for 5 points. Good job. We're back. We're still on pussies. Coined in Canada, what term describes an older woman who sexually pursues relationships with younger men? Oh, yellow mic, he's on down there.
Oh, cougar.
Is correct for 5.
I love that. He had a little kick. I like this one.
In use since the 20s, the mascot for Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer Studios is what animal?
Lion.
It is a lion. It's Leo. Good job. Here we go. Get ready. Still on pussies. It only takes 2 seconds for what land animal to go from 0 to 45 miles an hour?
Oh, a cheetah.
He's correct. Good job. Universally known by what nickname? Golfer? Eldrick Woods.
Oh,
is?
Tiger Woods.
Tiger Woods. So now you can prove, guys, that you all know all kinds of pussies. I think
okay.
That worked, right? Okay. Here we go. Next category, it's FU. Simple enough. Careful what you say. Once used in farming, what measurement is now used for distances in horse races?
Furlong.
Is correct for five. Good job.
Yeah.
F you. What is the name of the pivot on which a lever moves?
Fulcrum.
He's good. He's quick down here, guys. F you. What deep-fried sugary treat found at carnivals is named for the tool used to pour it into
funnel
the hollow
cake.
Oil? Funnel cakes, yes. Is your buzzer broken? Try it. Try it. It is broken. Try it. See, it's broken. It's broken. You're right.
Now,
now try it. Now, now push his. See, I was just screwing with you. All right.
Can't take her anywhere. Can't take her anywhere.
F you. Here we go.
F me, F you.
Celine Dion's My Heart Will Go On is a popular song heard at what ceremonies to mark a person's passing?
A funeral.
Is correct for five. F you. What word describes the hip-hop bunch that was led by singer-turned-actor Mark Wahlberg?
Funky Bunch.
Funky Bunch is correct. Good job.
He's on the board!
Here, ring that bell. It'll make you feel good. Here. Next category, blow me. Think blow me. Craig's got this? Excellent. Right.
You know, he has that look about him, I think.
Think blow me. What was the name of the chimpanzee that Michael Jackson referred to as his first child?
Bubbles.
Bubbles. Blow me, Bubbles.
Renica.
What?
We have a winner.
What? No way. Oh, my God. Let's give him a hand, guys. Wow, I wasn't even paying attention. I got to watch these scores better. Nice job. What should we hook these guys up with? Oh, wait a minute. You give them pop rocks.
I don't know. She disappeared. Girl, you gonna make it?
What the hell? Something for you. Little hard on for everybody, why not?
Thanks, guys.
Russell Stover chocolates from Kansas City, guys. Woo!
All the way from Kansas City.
So.
You can have the box or the bag.
Oh, this one's different, too. This one's different. It's not the same. Going with her tight little box.
Bernie's yeah, okay. box.
Nobody wants my fat sack anymore.
We got your Russell Stovers.
Got some more chocolates.
And don't forget the condom. And Pop Rocks. Thanks for playing.
Awesome.
I don't play for the Pop Rocks. I play for the thrill of winning.
Yep.
Here we go.
Four more winners. Scream! Scream, bitches, scream! That one right there in the middle, get up here!
Yeah,
come
I gotta
with
come,
me, baby.
I gotta come,
with
come
me.
All the way back here. Who are they all pointing at? Oh, come on.
There's
oh, I
two.
Found
There's
one.
My two.
Renica, you'll like this one. And then what do we say? I think I saw a lady up here. Yes. Lady in the black. Representing for the females.
Oh, cool. Where's my really dirty questions?
I like your leggings. She's ready for disco night.
You guys
is everybody
ready to
gonna
dance
be at,
tonight?
Is everyone gonna be at the dance?
Oh man. I'll be easy to find. I got a rainbow moo-moo. It's that big. You'll find me, guys. I'll be right there underneath the mirror ball. Here we go. 5 points apiece for correct answers. Yellow microphone. What's your name, honey? Hit that buzzer for me.
Adriana, Los Angeles.
Adriana from Los Angeles.
Excellent. Excellent. Reset this. There we go. Test number two, you got a green mic. What's your name?
Tony from Seattle.
Tony from Seattle. That's a long walk, too. Yeah. Blue microphone. What's your name?
Bill, Bucks County, New Hope.
Excellent. Wow. Thank you so much for joining us. Down here in the end, you got a red mic. What's your name, beautiful?
Garth from Appleton, Wisconsin.
Excellent. Thank you so much for joining us. This is great. Everybody from all around the world. Wow. So cool.
So what do you do in Appleton? I got to know. You're a retired teacher. Did you teach at the school there? What's the school there?
Houdini Elementary.
I auditioned for a school there once. What's the school there? In Appleton, the big college with the music program? Lawrence University. See? I knew I'd been there.
I went to FU. Here we go, guys. 5 points apiece. I want to finish some blow me questions here because these are fun. Ready on your buzzer. 5 points apiece for correct answers. Used by police to test a person's blood alcohol level, what device was originally the size of a shoebox?
Breathalyzer.
He's correct. He's got the first five. Good job. Here we go. Yeah. Next question. Blow me. The sight of piercings in some Native American cultures, the nasal septum is the cartilage in what face part?
Prince Albert.
You can blow a Prince Albert, I do believe. If I've heard correctly.
Is that worth 5 points? Is it? It is? I'll give it to him.
I think you should investigate, Renica. Does he really know what he's talking about? Oh, I'm coming over here. My research was inconclusive.
We'll tell you more in the morning. Here we go. Nose was the correct answer I was looking for. Blow me. So what metal instrument is used by referees to stop gameplay?
Whistle.
The whistle is correct for five down there. Good job, honey. I'm just going to throw you some silly questions here just to kind of mix up a little bit. We're going to try a couple funny ones here. Let's see if you guys can give me the correct answer I'm looking for, which I'm not going to get, I'm sure. 5 points. First person can buzz in. Get your hands ready. Buzz in and tell me, what is a bunghole?
The hole in a cask of whiskey.
Wine or beer is correct. Yes.
Nice. Smell you, Nancy Drew.
Nice. Wow.
Good God.
Make some noise for the alcoholics. Hell, I mean, I didn't even know that one. I was thinking something else. Even when I wrote this, I went, no. You know, it's even funnier than that. That's a bunghole. It's the hole for the entrance of the contents inside of a whiskey, wine, or beer keg. What's even funnier is the cork is called a bung. And there's a guy that 40 hours a week, he stands there with a wooden mallet and hits those bungs as they go past. And this is what's even funnier. I'll give you 5 points if you can buzz in and tell me, what is the title of his job? What is his title?
Top.
The top, that's a good answer. That's a good answer. That's a good answer, I like that.
I like him, he can stay.
A bung pounder?
It is a bung pounder, that's right. How did it? Wow.
I know how to pick a Renica.
All right, so while we're there, let's try another one of those. What is a cockhead? You're in.
M.
What is a cockhead? No idea. Buzz in, guys.
A chicken.
She's got it. What?
A chicken.
It's the top of a grinding mill spindle, believe it or not. Who names this stuff? Right, I'm going to try another one for you. I bet the teacher will get this one. Spelled C-U-M-M-I-N-G-T-O-N-I-T-E. What the fuck is coming tonight? Buzz in if you got the correct answer. Oh, hit that again for me.
A rare mineral.
It's a type of mineral composed of magnesium, iron, silicate. Yes, good job. That is coming tonight, and we'll talk about your answer later. Not to be confused with a shuttlecock or a horsecock. What is a dick ass?
A what?
Richard Nixon's nickname.
A dick ass.
Oh, specifically the correct answer I was looking for. Nobody? Audience?
No.
Donkey. Yeah, it's a dick ass. Here we go. Bald eagles fall thousands of feet from the sky while they are blank.
Going and getting their prey. Going hunting and eating their prey.
That would be diving.
Catching their prey.
This is actually, they just fall out of the sky. Bald eagles fall thousands of feet from the sky while mating. Yeah, that's correct.
All right.
Thought I'd try you a couple. Yeah, they group together and they just get it on, and about 500 foot off the ground, they give up. I don't know.
Is that how you do it too, Renica?
Normally.
Just jump.
Normally. 5 points to give me the correct answer I'm looking for. Bats have the highest rate of blank of any mammal.
What?
What's your answer?
What?
Blood. No. Bats have the highest rate of blank amongst any mammals.
Herpes.
Poppers. Rabies.
No. Believe it or not, guys, it's homosexuality.
Really?
Yay, Batman. Speaking of Batman, the penguin only has one single blank in a year. Oops.
Testicle?
Penguin only has one single blank in a year. She's got
intercourse or mating.
You know, I don't know how many times they do it, but they only have one of these a year. Penguin only has one single blank a year.
Orgasm
is correct.
Oh, wow.
They are the most frigid little motherfuckers, I'll tell you. Yep. All right, silly stuff here. Next question. Supposedly, they scare them terribly so, and maybe this is why, the sperm of a blank is actually longer than the sperm of an elephant.
What is the whale?
You're talking about the tallywhacker itself, baby. That's 10 foot long and a foot wide. It's the sperm, actually. Supposedly, they scare them terribly so. Not who has the largest sperm. It's they have a larger sperm than an elephant. It's why they scare them so much. No? I kind of lost you guys with that. A mouse, yeah.
Mouse?
Yeah. Yeah. It's longer. I don't know how that is, but... I want to hit you guys with some more dirty minds. I like playing the dirty minds from earlier. We're going to go with things that start with the letter S. Things that start with the letter S. I'll give you the first one. It's two words. You ready? I can hold your meat. If what you put inside me is too small, it could slip out. And sometimes a baby comes out of me. That's odd. Two words. Uh-oh, who's in?
Shit can.
Shopping cart was the answer I was looking for. That didn't work. That one didn't work.
If I ever get a baby, don't let me give it to him.
Things that start with letter S. After I'm done, I still drip a little. After you've been inside me, you should wipe yourself off.
Shower.
Shower is correct. Yes, good job. Not what he was thinking. Not what he was thinking.
Renica.
What? Again? Oh, my God.
We have a winner.
Hit that bell. Hit that bell. Yay. Nice job. Bernie, what do we got for the other guys? We got something for them still?
Yep.
Hook them up with a drink card for our friends.
Don't make me chase you.
Back in Fort Lauderdale. Uh-oh, where'd you guys run off to? How about four more winners?
Well, we have to hook our prize.
What's he going to take? Does he want the big fat sack?
Do you want the bag or the box? He's going with your bag.
Oh, boy. I loved when I found these. Isn't that cute? Nice little princess pillow. Something to lay your head on the plane on the way home, baby. Congratulations. Yay. What do you think, Bernie? Thank you guys so much for joining us in the Dirty Game Show.
Make some notes. some notes. Make some noise for your hostess, my good gal pal and coho, Renica.
Thank you, guys.
My name's Bernadette. Thanks so much for coming. You can catch us at 9 o'clock on Thursday and again at 9 o'clock on Saturday. And then on the pool deck tonight.
That's the Dirty Game Show, guys. Welcome to winning, fellas. Thank you.